Control and Rhythm Nation. It is a tremendous by the Jacksons' parents, Joe and Catherine, but it's a legacy that apparently does not include LaToya. 2300 Jackson Street. Her estrangement from her own family was never more evident than in the 1989 video, 2300 Jackson Street. All the Jacksons appeared in the video except LaToya, who declined to participate. 2300 Jackson Street is where the children grew up in Gary, Indiana. And according to LaToya, it was a home with many secrets, especially for the boys and their father, Joe.
When they first began as the Jackson Five and he started rehearsing them, he would beat them to make them to rehearse continuously.
LaToya writes that her mother, Catherine, was a part of the pattern of abuse.
You must understand, it's not just my father, it's my mother too. I've seen him beat one of my brothers. And my mother sit there and she watches. She won't say anything, and she let it happen. She won't say, Joe, but why are you hitting him? He hasn't done anything. She sits there and she let it happen.
LaToya claims that she too was beaten.
My father beat me, and he beat me, and he beat me. And then he threw me in the bathroom and he closed the door. He beat me with a belt buckle and a switch.
How did all this abuse affect the family?
My brothers are grown now, and they have all approached me at different times. And they've cried, and they've said, I'm terribly afraid of my father. It's a shame, but I can't stand to be in the same room with him. And they would always refer to him as, I hate him, I hate him. I ain't gonna stop
till I hit the top. LaToya does perform in nightclubs, and she has made several videos. But she has not enjoyed any major hit records, and she says her career has been repeatedly stymied by her parents, especially her mother. She says her decision to appear nude in Playboy in 1989 was a direct slap at her parents, and that her brother Michael supported her completely in the matter of the Playboy pictures.
He says, I want you to know that they're fabulous, they're wonderful. He called me 2 weeks later and said, do me a favor. And I said, what is it? Don't let anyone know that I told you this. And the only reason that I'm telling this and saying this, Michael, if you're listening, is to help you. Again, you're covering up your true feelings, you're hiding, and you shouldn't do that. Express yourself and let it out. That's what's wrong with the family. We led a very sheltered life, and no one knows the true family, how they really are.
In an obvious and stark contrast to 2300 Jackson Street, LaToya Jackson describes her entire family as dysfunctional. She says she hopes her brothers and sisters will come forward now to support her version of growing up in the Jackson family. Garrett Glazer, Entertainment Tonight.
The Jackson family issued a statement to Entertainment Tonight expressing their love for LaToya and saying, like any family, the Jacksons have had their differences. The statement continued, quote, we do not care to elaborate nor narrate on LaToya's book nor the things she is doing. Since there is no truth or validity to the accusations made, we think it's best to let the book ride its own course, end quote.
I guess it's one thing for a woman to write a book about harsh relationships with her parents while she was growing up, but does a gentleman write a book about his love affairs? If you're Geraldo Rivera, you do just that, and the stories he tells involve some of the biggest names in politics and show business.
A man who is sexually promiscuous is a stud. A woman who's sexually promiscuous is a slut.
In his new autobiography titled Exposing Myself, Geraldo Rivera writes of how he took full advantage of what he calls the dual standard of sexual roles in society, and he names his conquests. He told R. Nancy Collins he cheated on his wife-to-be with Bette Midler in the early 70s.
I was a user of women. It was, and I enjoyed them. I was a connoisseur, really. And Bette was the sexiest woman on earth.
According to Rivera, his admitted womanizing included a fling with tennis star Chris Evert and affairs with Marion Javits, wife of former Senator Jacob Javits, and Margaret Trudeau, wife at the time of the Prime Minister of Canada. But Rivera says he had an odd relationship with Liza Minnelli.
Liza and I flirted for over 10 years, and we'd come together like, either two dogs in heat kind of sniffing each other or a rooster and a chicken, and somehow she liked that tension, but she never wanted it to go the final step.
Rivera writes that some women, like Barbara Walters, were merely amused by his advances and what he calls his eternal quest for the next woman. But Rivera says he changed his ways when he married fourth wife, Cece.
Finally, Geraldo the boy became Geraldo the man. I swear that for the last 4+ years, I've been the best husband in America.
No none of the women mentioned by Geraldo could be reached for comment. His book hits the market later this week, and Nancy Collins will have an in-depth profile of Geraldo next week on Entertainment Tonight. Now, on our inside story tomorrow, it's lights, camera, and plenty of action as Indiana Jones heads to the small screen.
It's, you know, every acting fantasy I've ever had. You know, it's culminated into one big ball.
Behind the scenes on the Indiana Jones television series, our inside story tomorrow on Entertainment Tonight.
Coming up next, a final tribute to a legendary country singer, Dottie West. And a little later, James Earl Jones tries to come up with an encore after winning a fistful of Emmys.
I've got great news for everyone who uses bleach to clean up the kitchen and bath. New Clorox Cleanup is a bleach specially designed for cleaning. You see, Clorox added a special cleaner to bleach, so it cleans even better. Now you can clean up stains, clean up germs, and clean up greasy dirt bleach alone leaves behind. So, when you reach for a bleach to clean up, reach for the one with a special cleaner inside. New Clorox Cleanup. Cleans like bleach, only better.
Introducing new Tylenol Allergy Sinus Gel Caps. Because allergies can be more than watery eyes, more than itching, more than sneezing. Many come with sinus pressure and pain. But the leading allergy brand has only an antihistamine. Tylenol Allergy Sinus has more. A decongestant and a pain reliever to relieve all your allergy symptoms. It's more complete relief. Tylenol Allergy Sinus. Allergy relief clear to your sinuses.
To get ahead in tomorrow's world, the children of today need to be challenged, to stretch their imaginations beyond normal limits. A quality education will help. ACME has a program for schools to earn free IBM computers, printers, bands, science, audiovisual equipment, and more. Helping your school earn free equipment is fast and easy. How easy? Shop ACME. Save the blue register receipts and proofs of purchase from these brands. Shop ACME today and help to build a better tomorrow.
Long trips wear people out. It's the same with chickens and turkeys. By the time they get to your grocer, they could be anything but fresh. But Wobbler Longacre chickens and turkeys come from farms no more than a day from your grocer. So you can enjoy all Wobbler Longacre products at the peak of freshness and taste. Wobbler Longacre. We're so fresh because we're so close. Pack a healthy, tasty lunch kids will love with Wobbler Longacre sliced lunch meats.
Dottie West is being remembered tonight as one of the pioneers of country music. She died today at the age of 58 from injuries suffered in a car accident last week.
I was raised on country sunshine.
Dottie West recorded 52 albums and was best known for her bouncy hit Country Sunshine. Always looking on the bright side, she had hoped that recent financial problems were behind her and she was on the road to a comeback when tragedy struck. On Friday, a car she was riding in crashed into an off-ramp on the way to the Grand Ole Opry. At a press conference today, her manager said she received an outpouring of support as she fought for her life through the weekend.
Yeah, we've received a lot of calls from not only Dottie's fellow singers, but actors, friends from all over the world, and her fans who prayed and called about her.
Here comes my baby.
Dottie was the first woman to win a Country Music Grammy Award in 1964 for the hit Here Comes My Baby. But she reached the pinnacle of her success in the late 70s when she recorded several popular duets with Kenny Rogers, who became a close friend and who visited her in the hospital.
I think that Dottie West, as much or more than anyone I ever met, when she sang about pain, she felt that pain. And when she sang about love, I mean, she could be in love for that moment.
At the height of her career, she was making $1 to $2 million a year. She bought a mansion in Nashville and filled it with mementos. There were happy times with her four children. Then in 1990, misfortune caught up with her. Financial problems forced her to file bankruptcy, and the bank foreclosed on her home.
It's just devastating. I'm sorry. I never thought it would come to this.
Putting those troubled times behind her, Dottie had embarked on an ambitious concert tour and was planning to write a book. She was optimistic about the future.
I have not written nor have I sang my best song yet, but I will, I hope.
One of her oldest friends, country singer Tammy Wynette, says she'll always remember Dottie's wonderful sense of pride and dignity. Funeral arrangements are still pending.
Stars win Emmys and Oscars for performances that make you believe in what they're doing. And that talent is what makes celebrities the best at selling TV commercials. Who are the most popular? Here they come in this brief commercial message. The Cosby reign continues in the world of commercials. For the seventh straight year, Bill Cosby heads up Video Storyboard's list of the most appealing celebrity spokespeople. That's what it's all about. Video Storyboard president David Vedera says Cosby can thank his Jell-O Kid co-stars for his strong showing in the national survey.
He's always noticed for Jell-O because there he is always with children. And people find children to be very persuasive. And that rubs off on Cosby as well.
You got the right one, baby.
Piano man Ray Charles came in a strong second in the poll, with singer Paula Abdul skating her way into third.
Let's face it, 40 isn't fatal.
40 wasn't fatal for Linda Evans, who made the celebrity top 10. Others joining her on the list, Candace Bergen, Angela Lansbury, and rapper MC Hammer.
Papa.
Michael Jordan leapt to the top of the list of athlete endorsers, overtaking last year's winner, Bo Jackson.
Stop! This is ridiculous.
Vedera says sports stars have a natural edge in the advertising game.
They not only bring the same sort of recognition and the same sort of a pretty face, but they also bring the sense of fitness, that they are fit people.
Now everybody knows how much I love to eat.
Dodger manager Tommy Lasorda proved effective as a product pitcher, placing third on the list. Also making the grade, Joe Montana, Nolan Ryan, wrestler Hulk Hogan, Arnold Palmer, and Mr. Baseball himself, Mr. Front Row, Bob Uecker.
You're in the wrong seat, buddy. Come on.
Oh, I must be in the front row.
This is the first year there have been more women than men in the top category. Experts say that's because advertisers used to hire authority figures. Now they just hire whoever is most appealing.
The new book, Three Blind Mice, is about the declining state of affairs at ABC, NBC, and CBS. Now its author is claiming he has been banned from the airwaves because he's written the book the networks don't want you to read.
And his new book...
He details his arguments in a book called...
We're going to talk in this half hour with an author, with a lawyer.
Publishers love to book their authors on the Today Show. Ken Auletta was scheduled to talk about his new book, Three Blind Mice, on this morning's program, but was axed. According to NBC, it wasn't newsworthy enough. Auletta hasn't appeared on the other two network morning shows and claims the book, which focuses on the decline of the three networks, is too hot to handle.
The networks have a First Amendment obligation, and that is not to abuse their power because a book makes them uncomfortable. And I think this book has made many people at the networks uncomfortable, and they're trying to do exactly what Pravda did in the Soviet Union, which is keep out certain news.
Auletta had the full cooperation and was given unprecedented access to the highest levels of all three networks.
I had 6 years, which I took to do this book. You have time to wear people down and convince them that they should cooperate, that you're doing something that's historical, that will live on bookshelves for hopefully more than a year.
He details network executives' biggest blunders, including CBS's Larry Tisch, who called Dan Rather and other newsmen the biggest bunch of liars. 60 Minutes' Andy Rooney came under attack as an old blowhard who makes $400,000 a year for 2 minutes a week. The major question is why the execs allowed Auletta to document them in their most private moments.
I think people cooperate for lots of reasons. One is vanity. They believe if you get to be a success the way Jack Welch is as the head of General Electric, for instance, that they can take anyone, including some lowly reporter like me.
While he hasn't appeared on any ABC, NBC, or CBS shows, Auletta has already taped several interviews for CNN and Fox.
Entertainment Tonight. Bon Jovi guitarist Richie Sambora knew he was in for a star-packed evening when he kicked off the release of his new album at a Los Angeles observatory. Sambora was celebrating the release of his first solo album. His former girlfriend Cher showed up, as well as Paul Stanley of Kiss.
I think it's really great.
I'm a very lucky guy. I'm almost speechless at the moment. It's great.
At New York's Plaza Hotel, an international bevy of girls were contestants and elite models in Maybelline's Look of the Year competition.
A lot of the contestants who don't even place end up being supermodels.
Of the 10 finalists, only one had the look.
And the girl with the Look of the Year 1991... Ingrid Sinhaver from Belgium.
And in Hollywood, the rock group Poison, rapper LL Cool J, and Paula Abdul were rehearsing their acts for Thursday night's MTV Video Music Awards.
It's culture shock. You know, basically, I mean, you have a lot of cultures that might not have necessarily came in contact with each other, meeting and shaking hands, and it's interesting.
A second honeymoon for James Earl Jones next.
How are a growing number of American men describing the ideal woman?
Fat is where it's at. Less is not best.
They say fat is another word for beautiful and that women of size are sexy.
Fat, large, I just find that attractive.
Find out why men are becoming chubby chasers tonight on Evening Magazine.
They want to do their taxes, but they need your help. Volunteer. Call 1-800-TAX-1040 and join the IRS Volunteer Assistance Programs.
It's Clover Day at Strawbridge and Clothier. Send your S&C kids back to school with 30% off girls' leggings, tops, and skirts. 30% off at Clover Day.
I did my part.
Do yours. Johnny Dawkins is back.
She's a fit mate. Joining Weight Watchers and losing weight, it's like a rebirth. So it's that powerful feeling. Nobody can give that to you. Nobody can. You can. There's things that we can change about our lives. There's a lot of things we can't change. But we can absolutely change our weight. Absolutely.
Weight Watchers, you've got it in you to get it off you.
Pay only $10. That's free registration when you join Weight Watchers by September 28th. So join Weight Watchers now.
Some folks have asked me why I'm running for the Senate. It's simple. I love this state, and I think there's more we can do. Back when I was governor, we did a lot of great things together. But my first priority was making sure people were working, that they had jobs. I'm afraid we're getting away from that. If we fight for good jobs, a lot of other good things will happen. That's what I'd be honored to do. Fight for Pennsylvania. Again. Thanks.
Give your child the key that will open any door. Make reading important every day. Write to this address for more information on the Book It Reading Incentive Program in your school.
Gabriel's Fire may have been a hot streak at the Emmy Awards this year, but you won't see it listed in TV Guide. That's because ABC has changed the name of the show to Pros and Cons, and that's not the only change they have in store. Take a look. Both leading actors in Gabriel's Fire won Emmys, and both are now central in Pros and Cons. James Earl Jones says it's no coincidence.
The two characters that were salvaged from Gabriel's Fire were the two characters that were celebrated by the Emmy Awards, too. And I think that's confirmation that those two characters were working. There's something about them were working.
Oh, my.
His romantic lead is Madge Sinclair, who wasn't on hand to pick up her Emmy. Her personal life, celebrating her husband's birthday, was more important.
I thought holding on to my marriage was a little bit more important, so I went for the weekend, and I had a marvelous time, and the surprise was winning.
Close enough.
In Pros and Cons, Private Investigator Jones picks up a sidekick, played by Richard Crenna, who plans to make this show a bit lighter. He also kidded his colleagues about their awards.
Well, I'm a little bored with James and his Emmy and Madge and her Emmy. I have one too, you know, so it's okay. Everybody should have their turn. Andy Warhol said, we all have our 15 seconds in the sun, and we're thrilled, obviously.
We do.
For Gabriel's Fire fans, there is a payoff in the new show. Jones and Madge get married. It was Jones's idea, but Sinclair, she's not so sure.
Yeah, I'm hoping that we can put some spice into it even though we're married. Doesn't mean we have to be dull.
As for Jones, he says he likes the idea of getting married on the show because he thinks it will add a little mystery to the story.
James Earl Jones certainly has always been an imposing presence on stage and on screen. So is Orson Welles. But as Leonard Maltin is going to point out, some of Orson Welles' greatest work was done behind the camera. Hello, Leonard.
Hi, Mary. It certainly is true. Orson Welles' acting career flourished for some 40 years on screen, but his directing career, which started on such an incredible high note with Citizen Kane, was a study in frustration, filled with unrealized projects and recutting of his films by other people. Still, every Orson Welles movie is a movie worth seeing. And since the 50th anniversary edition of Citizen Kane is just out on video, this is as good a time as any to salute Orson Welles on video.
Rosebud.
An unforgettable opening line in what many call the greatest film ever made, Citizen Kane.
Orson Welles' technical innovations in this classic are stunning. And his performance as newspaper tycoon Charles Foster Kane is right on the money.
You're right, Mr. Thatcher. I did lose $1 million last year. I expect to lose $1 million this year. I expect to lose $1 million next year. You know, Mr. Thatcher, at the rate of $1 million a year, I'll have to close this place in 60 years.
The magnificence of the Ambersons was as conspicuous as a brass band at a funeral.
How do you follow a debut like Kane? Welles adapted and directed the Booth Tarkington novel, The Magnificent Ambersons. And although he didn't appear in the film, many of his stock company did. This quaint period piece about a family clinging to its aristocratic past.
Lawyers, bankers, politicians. What do they ever get out of life, I'd like to know? What do they know about real things? What do they ever get?
What do you want to be?
A yachtsman.
Well, here was a beautiful girl all by herself and me with plenty of time, nothing to do but get myself into trouble. Some people can smell danger. Not me.
Rita Hayworth lures Welles into a web of deceit and murder in The Lady from Shanghai. This strange tale comes to a typically Wellesian conclusion amidst the odd angles of a funhouse carnival of mirrors.
Just because he speaks a little guilty, that don't make him innocent, you know.
You can show motive, yes, but won't you need a bit more than that?
Yeah, we'll get it.
In Touch of Evil, Welles plays a corrupt police detective who'll stop at nothing to throw narcotics agent Charlton Heston off the scent. And be sure to look for Marlena Dietrich as a local madam who gives an ironic assessment of Welles' by now fading career behind the camera.
Come on, read my future for me.
You haven't got any.
That was pretty well true at that time. Luckily, we do have those films that do exist, and they're all worth seeing, and they're all on video.
Thanks, Leonard.
Thank you, Leonard. The ET Insider is here with some things sure aren't what they used to be news. A company called Topps has been selling bubble gum and tossing in free baseball trading cards as a sales gimmick since the year 1952. Now the Insider learns that Topps will sell only the baseball cards, many of which have become collector's items over the years, and they will leave out the gum because it was making the cards sticky and difficult to sell. And sell is now the key word at the South Fork Mansion, made famous in the Dallas television series. The oil-rich Ewings did all manner of grand and expensive things at South Fork when they ruled the roost in prime time. Now that Dallas has disappeared from the TV airwaves, South Fork has been repurchased by its original owner. He called the Insider to say the ranch is being turned into a flea market beginning this weekend. There will be thousands of vendors, some of them selling baseball cards with or without gum. And the Insider shudders to wonder what J.R. would think.
If you've been thinking about losing weight, now you can do it and help others at the same time. Because this month, you can join our introductory program for only $19, and we'll donate that entire amount to Easter Seals. Which means you'll be helping people with disabilities do many things most of us take for granted. Just call 1-800-92-JENNY and join us to lose weight and help others.
Ah, those dependable Hondas. They start at home, they start at work, and best of all, they start at a lot less than you might think. Buy a 1991 Honda today. At these prices, what's stopping you?
Bad news, Pizza Hut pepperoni. Prepare to get picked on even more.
Why is everybody always picking on me?
Why? Because now you can get a pepperoni lover's pizza at a very pickable price. Get one for just $8.99 or two for a paltry $4 more. With two prolific pilings of pepperoni packed between two heaping portions of cheese and a particularly low price, who can resist picking?
Why is everybody always picking on me?
You know why.
Making it great.
Watch the feathers fly Sunday, September 8th. The Eagles battle the Phoenix Cardinals in the Bird season opener at the Vet. Catch the game action and share in the Eagles' halftime tribute to five-time Pro Bowler Mike Quick. Call 215-463-5500 for game tickets or stop by the Eagles ticket office at the Vet or any Ticketmaster outlet. Don't miss the Battle of the Birds Sunday, September 8th. Get your tickets now by calling 463-5500. Don't be shut out.
By popular demand,
Bally's Holiday holds over the pay-as-you-go program with the lowest enrollment fee ever, $49. Once you join, you pay only $15 a month for as long as you want. No high membership fees, no long-term commitments, just $15 a month for aerobics, swimming, jogging, and the most advanced equipment available, including our 30-minute workout. Join Bally's Holiday pay-as-you-go program. Act now. This incredible offer won't last long. Call 1-800-WORKOUT.
Air travel furnished and a promotional fee paid by Delta Airlines. Fly to your favorite sunspot on Delta, Florida, the Bahamas, California, Mexico, or Hawaii. At Delta, we love to fly, and it shows.
Celebrating a birthday today, actor Danny Ponce is 19. Actress Judith Ivey is 40. Actress Mitzi Gaynor turned 61. And actor Dick York is 63.
Tonight we're going to close the show with a tribute to Dottie West. She was the first woman ever to win a Grammy for country music.
Here she is now singing the song that earned her that award. It's called Here Comes My Baby. Enjoy it. See ya.
And my arms are open wide to let more hurt inside. Here comes my baby back again. Once more I'll understand. Here comes my baby back again. Here comes my baby back again. 1965.
In just a minute, we'll meet some men who say when it comes to a good woman, the more the better. Chubby Chasers, next on Evening Magazine.
There's a storm brewing at your Lincoln Mercury dealer. A summer savings storm. And the forecast is for great deals on everything from Tracer to Town Car. Get low 2.9 APR financing for 48 months on Mercury Tracer. Save $1,000 on Capri Convertible. $1,250 on Sable Sedan or Wagon. Make your best deal on the 92 Grand Marquis. Save over $6,000 with low red carpet lease rates and even more with factory to dealer cash on all 91 Lincolns. The summer savings storm is headed your way, so seek shelter at your local Lincoln Mercury dealer now.
To get ahead in tomorrow's world, children need a quality education. ACME has a program for schools to earn free IBM computers and more. It's fast and easy. Shop ACME, save your blue register receipt and proofs of purchase from these brands, and save money with these super hot prices. Chiquita Golden Ripe Bananas, 4 pounds for a dollar. Breyers Ice Cream, assorted flavors, $1.99 a half gallon. And Charmin Bath Tissue in the 4-pack, now at ACME, just 89 cents. Shop ACME today and help to build a better tomorrow.
This Eagles memorable moment is brought to you by Rosenbluth, the high-performance travel people.
1960, Franklin Field. The Eagles complete a remarkable season by beating the Green Bay Packers for the World Championship 17-13. It is the only time a Vince Lombardi coach team would ever lose a postseason game. And to date, the Eagles' last championship.
The Weather Tonight with David Rogers, weeknights at 11.
Tonight on Evening Magazine, men who like their women with a few extra pounds.
I've always liked curves. I always liked them curvy, so I've never really been attracted to the Vogue or the Playboy or the Cosmopolitan type thing.
Not every woman has the perfect figure, and for some men, that's quite all right. Plus, what do Michael J. Fox and Leslie Nielsen have in common? Find out tonight.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ray Murray.
I'm Pat Shiraki. Every single day, we are bombarded by television, movie, and magazine images of perfectly slim American women. I hate them. You have to admit that those images rarely reflect reality.
Well, the truth is that millions of women are beyond a size 6, and there are millions of men who are perfectly happy about that. Here's Evening's Jim Dever with the story of America's fat admirers.
Hi, I'm Don Bowen, Sagittarian.
Don Bowen is looking for the woman of his dreams. Slender beauties need not apply.
Fat, large,
I just find that attractive.
Don is one of a growing number of American men who are publicly stating their preference for women of size and saying fat is just another word for beautiful.
I've always liked curves. I always liked them curvy, so I've never really been attracted to the Vogue or the Playboy or the Cosmopolitan type thing.
Society's accepted standards of beauty hold little allure for so-called fat admirers. For these men, thin is definitely not in.
Kind of having a slight preference more for the larger woman gives me a wider range of selection, I guess I'd say. I hate my phone bill.
And Don's not alone. There are entire computer networks devoted to self-proclaimed chubby chasers and the women they're trying to meet. One even features fantasy fiction for the bigger is better crowd. Stories that range from tame to torrid.
Here you have adult interests, fat topics, feeders only. There's guys out there who like imagine fantasize feeding somebody and fattening them. Also, if we go to fat topics.
Now, wait a minute. What is that?
There are a group of guys out there who idea of watching a woman get fatter is very erotic to them, so they're called feeders. And so they like to imagine, you know, feeding a woman and making her fatter.
Okay.
Let's see, so here we have...
I guess anything goes.
Yeah.
Fat admirers, including Don, are even featured in their own matchmaking magazine, where they can be discovered by the women they desire.
So I just decided to do it just to see what would happen.
And what happened?
Well, so far I've gotten 23 replies.
You're serious about your pumping, don't you?
For fat admirer Doug Zimmer, the search for a mate ended 12 years ago when he met his wife, Diane. Now they have two children and spend much of their time actively involved in a group that supports fat rights.
Doug, were you ever attracted to thin women?
Not really. I mean, I could appreciate what other men saw in women. I some of the same features appeal to me, but in a different class.
Men like Doug and Don say they simply find that size is sexy, the way some guys like tall women or others prefer a certain hair color, and they're tired of having to explain their attraction.
If you say, I like fat women, what happened in your childhood to make you prefer fat women instead of the society's ideal? Like if you say, oh, I like redheads, what happened in your childhood to make you prefer redheads? Did a blonde drop you as a baby so you don't like blondes anymore?
I wonder if he really is.
But even the women these men love sometimes question their motivation.
I tend to think that they want, they have an underdog syndrome before they have a fat admirer syndrome, that they are so into nurturing and caring for the underdog that, hey, being fat is the last frontier of prejudice.
Okay, now I have a feeling, Doug, you're going to disagree with some of that.
Sure. Yeah. Sure.
No, she did it very well, but she does have it exactly backwards. And after I met Diane, first I had to convince her that I was physically attracted to her, not just platonically. That seems kind of backwards, but it was true.
A lot of them find it hard to accept because of all the prejudice that they've had and all the bad reactions to them.
But big women, rest assured, there are plenty of men who find you attractive and sexy just the way you are.
Enjoy your differences, not only in the way you are, but in your preferences too.
Don't worry about what society says. What do they know?
Fat is where it's at. Less is not best.
As you saw, fat admirers come in many sizes and shapes, and yes, there are plenty of women who prefer a full-figured man.
Funny you should mention that, Pat. Now, you've heard of the Chippendales, those disgusting
kind of
muscular men who blatantly display their bodies to hordes of screaming women, right?
Yes.
Well, in Albuquerque, New Mexico, Patricia, there is a group of men called the Chunkendales. They're featured in a pictorial in The Globe. Now, these guys, Pat, are just plain fat, as you can see right there. It was originally an idea to raise money for charity, so we're not sure if it's going to catch on, but you do have to admit that it does have some weight behind it.
I'm glad it's for charity. The only thing is, I'm not sure where you would put the dollar bills.
Ooh, good question.
Coming up tomorrow, a look at the Eagles cheerleader tryouts, and you can be sure all the women were slim and trim. You have to have just the right moves to make the squad, but you also have to know the game. Find out just how tough the competition really is on the next Evening Magazine. Up next, from Michael J. Fox to Martin Short, Canadian actors are taking over Hollywood. What's their secret? Find out next.
the value of the quarter has just risen dramatically. Now it'll buy any donut we make at Dunkin' Donuts. Because after we dipped our chocolates, powdered our powders, and fancied up our frosteds, we sharpened our pencils to give you an incredible price. So while the value of the quarter is up, hurry on down to Dunkin' Donuts. And for a limited time, get any one of our 52 varieties for just 25 cents.
You want it. You need it. The prices are unbelievable. So what are you waiting for?
The anniversary sale that started it all.
You work like a dog. You definitely could use some great new stuff.
These are the most beautiful things we've ever had in the store.
Don't you just love the basement?
Trust us. When the basement says the whole store is on sale, you better believe it. Starts Friday, 9 a.m., early.
You snooze, you lose.
Filene's Basement. Of course we'd do it better. We did it first.
You tell me. Are they crazy?
The anniversary sale at Oscar Huber is on now, celebrating 64 years of fine home furnishings, excellent service, and incredible prices. Every item is on sale. In fact, you won't find it anywhere for less. We guarantee it. This week, a Pennsylvania House solid cherry dining room is just $39.99. Save 40% on the entire line of Pennsylvania House furniture. And this king coil bed, twin and full size, is $199. King and queen size is $349. Save 40% on all king coil bedding. The Oscar Huber anniversary sale ends soon in Philadelphia, Southampton, and Ship Bottom, New Jersey.
If you've been thinking about losing weight, now you can do it and help others at the same time. Because this month, you can join our introductory program for only $19, and we'll donate that entire amount to Easter Seals. Which means you'll be helping people with disabilities do many things most of us take for granted. Just call 1-800-92-JENNY and join us to lose weight and help others.
In the earliest days of Hollywood, many of America's favorite stars haven't been Americans at all. From Sweden's Greta Garbo to Austrian Arnold Schwarzenegger, foreign celebrities have often ruled the USA.
And while you may not have noticed, the latest showbiz invasion has come from our neighbors to the north. Here's our all-American Jim Dever with the story of those celebrities from Canada.
We're taking over. It's great. We're doing great, guys.
Have you taken a look at Hollywood lately? If so, you're probably seeing red and white, the colors of the Canadian flag.
You know the Canadians are really doing well in show business when Leslie Nielsen is like the biggest star, and it's great.
But Canadian Leslie Nielsen has plenty of company as a slew of northern stars capture movie screens across the good old USA. Besides Michael J. Fox, there's John Candy.
Wow, that's very good. That's a talent.
Keanu Reeves.
No way.
And Martin Short, to name a few. While Arnold the Austrian packs movie muscle, the English bring an air of sophistication, and the French, romance, Canadians have their own cinema secret weapons, humility and humor.
I don't know. It's hard to generalize, but I think that we have a capacity to laugh at ourselves.
Entertainment columnist Elizabeth Aird of the Vancouver Sun says her fellow countrymen staged their cinematic sweep with a disarming dose of friendliness.
There seems to be a lack of cynicism about them. They're fresh and they're funny and they're kind of sweet.
Oh, sure, of course. Yeah, that.
But if you think Canucks are taking over the big screen, just look at what's happening on your TV.
Okay, let's go. We're firing Patriots.
NBC's newest golden boy, Canadian Arthur Kent, went from Scud Stud to Today Show temp, substituting for Bryant Gumbel.
The guys in the desert are never going to believe this.
But Kent is just the latest in a long line of television journalists and actors that hail from the Northlands, from America's most successful TV lawyer to its most courageous space captain.
I don't know, William Shatner, what can I say? Captain Kirk came from Canada.
So why the mass immigration? Well, as a country with one-tenth the population of its southern neighbor, Canada simply can't afford the ambitions of its biggest stars.
The thing with the States is you just can't refuse that kind of money.
The lure of L.A. and millions of Yankee dollars extends beyond show business. 2 years ago, Canadian hockey hero Wayne Gretzky signed with the Los Angeles Kings and took a slap shot at Canadian pride.
I mean, hockey goes so deep in Canada, so deep, that it really is the dream of every little boy, you know, to grow up and play in the NHL. So to lose Gretzky.
How can you say that?
While, by and large, Canadians tend to be proud of their stateside achievements, they can't help but worry about losing all of their heroes.
I don't know. I think a lot of us worry about, you know, getting smothered.
Maclean's magazine had a contest a few years ago, and the idea of the contest was that you had to finish this sentence as Canadian as, the idea being that it would be like as American as apple pie or whatever. And the winner was as Canadian as possible under the circumstances. So, I think that's kind of the way we feel about ourselves. We know who we are, but this whole joking, this whole thing that everyone says about we're struggling for identity, I think we know who we are, and more importantly, we're willing to laugh at who we are.
And as long as Americans keep laughing along, Canadians will keep flooding the U.S. talent pool, finding fame and fortune in the lower 48.
I just hope they remember where they came from.
Some other Canadian celebrities we think of as our own include Donald Sutherland, Jacqueline Bisset, and game show hosts Monty Hall and Alex Trebek. Still ahead, get a good hearty laugh when you meet the stars of two hilarious shows, David Leisure and Katey Sagal, coming up next.
Only one Worcestershire is allowed to rest 2 long years until it's aged to the peak of flavor. Lee and Perrins. Introducing something we pulled out of our hat. Chiquita 100% Juice Blends. In 5 unexpected flavors. How exotic is the taste? Let's just say it's to the beat of a different drummer. Now in frozen.
You bought it, Matt. You gotta handle it.
If you buy something at Circuit City, then see it advertised for less, just come back. Our low price guarantee means you'll get the difference.
Excuse me?
Mm-hmm.
Last week I bought this.
Plus 10% of the difference.
And today I saw this. Just open the paper and there it was.
It's that easy.
There. That's it?
That's it.
Cool. Welcome to Circuit City,
where service is state of the art. Today is a beautiful day. You have 3 beautiful children. They look like you, but they're going to be doctors. Can your life get any better? Yes, because you're going to McDonald's to get real values at unreal prices. Only 59 cents for a regular hamburger, 69 cent cheeseburger, 99 cent chicken fajitas, and great deals on Happy Meals. You save money. You're smart, but your children, they're geniuses. Yes, life is good, and at these prices, it only gets better at McDonald's today.
Hello, I'm the president of Lee and Perrins, and our steak sauce is no good, so don't use it. Thank you.
Lee and Perrins steak sauce. The steak sauce only a cow could hate.
Considering the state of television these days, there are some times that the commercials are better than the shows themselves.
That's a good point. You know what commercials I'm enjoying these days? I love the Energizer Rabbit commercials. I think they're really creative, especially the scuba diving one lately. Have you seen that?
I know.
It's really great. Do you have a favorite commercial?
I do have a favorite commercial. I think that it's by Maxwell House, when the young man comes home from war and his mother is there and she hugs him and you go to the dripping coffee pot. And
speaking of drips, you are such a sap. Anything that makes you cry, right?
It's true, I get all filled up.
In our next story, we're going to meet a guy who became famous overnight because of his unforgettable lie through his teeth commercial character. We know him as Joe Isuzu. Now you'll know him as David Leisure.
His top speed is 300 miles per hour. And Isuzu dealers have millions in stock. So they're selling them for $9. And if you come in tomorrow, you'll get a free house.
For 3 years, we were hounded by the lying, conniving Joe Isuzu. And these commercials were so popular that the star of them may never get rid of that image.
See, you can trust me.
I don't think I have a choice. I think people are going to remember me as Joe Isuzu whether I want to or not, so I better enjoy it.
In fact, I drove it up here myself.
David Leisure is enjoying it every time he glances at his bank account. And recently, David landed a role on the hit NBC show, Empty Nest.
Hi, Westons! I wanted you to be the first to hear I volunteered to be part of a medical experiment.
But there's a savant who needs an idiot transplant?
Wrong, Carol. This is about sex. You remember sex. It's what your husband used to have with all those other women.
David says Empty Nest is proof that he's made it as an actor, although his talents actually materialized when he was an overweight child. By age 15, he had lost the fat, but he retained the class clown image he'd used to protect himself from jokes.
Because I could use this personality that I developed in plays. Also, they, when you get applause, you know, that felt a lot better than getting, you know, laughed at and pointed at.
Hello, we like to
David's first bona fide acting role came in the aviation farce, Airplane.
No thanks, we gave it the office.
But David couldn't grab any other acting jobs and soon found himself living out of his van.
Well, the living in the van was easy because I had, for goodness sakes, I had a whole van to live in. You know, that's pretty cool. But for the next 3 years, I was just trying to keep above water, you know, waiting on tables and, you know, being a waiter and making some money my first marriage had broken up and I had a little baby daughter that I had to pay child support for.
It gets 94 miles per gallon city.
3 years passed before David landed some minor commercials. But then came Joe Isuzu and fame and fortune. That led to another obnoxious role as Charlie Dietz on Empty Nest.
So, Charlie, what's the experiment?
Well, this group of researchers is testing a new drug. It's supposed to help men who have a low sex drive.
Charlie, I didn't know you had a low sex drive.
Don't. Let me explain. This is the sex drive of the average guy. This is me. This is me on Miracle Drug.
And David says the producer came to him.
And he just said, you want to do this part? And I said, yeah, definitely. And that's how I got the part. I didn't even have to audition for it. Pretty good, huh?
Hi, may I come in?
Sounds like his characters may be rubbing off on David. But he does remember struggling 12 years to achieve this fame. That's why he carefully watches his co-stars, Dinah Manoff, Christy McNichol, and especially Richard Mulligan.
He's just absolutely brilliant when he comes up with ideas that make things work. I mean, the man is phenomenal, and I'm trying to steal as much as I can from him.
Charlie, let me explain. This is the brain of a moron. This is your brain.
Manoff is serious, but she's more fun, and McNichol is just outrageous. But she's the first one with her lines.
Average guy.
And David hopes to be just as good. Network television is still new to him, but he's determined to retain his success.
Can I knock on wood right now? I don't want to blow anything, you know what I mean?
And Isuzu will accept marbles and seashells.
And probably the hardest job that David Leisure is going to face is getting people to forget Joe Isuzu.
David's character on Empty Nest is featured only about 3 times a season. While most actors would complain about too little camera time, David says he's ecstatic to be on a network show instead of commercials.
The American Family is taken to the extreme each week with the wacky comedy Married with Children. The Bundys are a riot a minute, led by Mom Peg Bundy. She shimmies around the house with the tightest spandex pants that you can find. But that may be impossible this season because Katey Sagal is here to tell us why. Hi, Katey. It's great to see you.
Hi, Pat.
Tell us what is happening to you this season.
Well, the Bundys are having a baby. So Peg won't be wearing spandex this season because I'm expanding daily. So it'll be a change of wardrobe, that's for sure.
So how are you going to achieve that within the role of Peg?
I, in real life, am pregnant, so they decided to write it into the show. And Peg's sort of take on this is that she wants to be super mom. She wants to give everything to this new baby that she never did to the others. So consequently, everybody gets even more neglected.
Well, we have a brief clip, and it is the announcement of you being pregnant, telling
Boy.
Dear Al.
Honey?
Yes?
Guess what?
What?
I'm pregnant, too!
It looks like it's going to be a great show for the premiere. Katey, you're very much a woman of the 90s. You are pregnant and you're not married. How do you personally relate to the Peg Bundy character?
Well, I have a really good time playing her. There's a part of, you know, I've always looked at Peg, and I have always looked at her as a very fun-loving person who kind of does whatever she wants. I mean, I really find her quite liberated, actually. You know, she chooses to stay home, so that's what she does. And I can relate to those qualities.
I also understand that in one of the early parts of your career, you were one of the harlots as a backup singer with Bette Midler. What was that experience like for you?
That was a great experience. I worked for years as a singer. My first professional work is as a singer. So I was on the road for a long time, and Bette was about 4 years I worked with Bette. It was really great.
Considering you're a singer, are you going to be singing lullabies to the new Bundy baby?
Well, I suppose Peg will do that. I, Katey, personally have been singing to my baby already. But yes, I guess Peg will be singing a few lullabies.
Katey, we wish you well. Thanks very much. And in case you were wondering, Katey's baby is due in December. Married with Children premieres on the Fox Network on September the 8th. We'll have more of Evening Magazine right after this.
I'm here to drop off my pictures of Hawaii.
Well, now at CVS, you get a double set of jumbo prints or a single set and a new roll of film for one low price.
I'll take the prints.
Take the film!
The film now.
Hey, tomorrow at CVS, when you're offered a double set of jumbo prints or a single set and a new roll of film for one low price, you'll take the film.
I'll take the film.
CVS. This was me, a slim, trim teenage heartthrob. This was me 30 years later. Man, those years add up, right around the waistline. But then my daughter Julie said, Dad, Nutrisystem.
They helped me lose 17 pounds. They can help you, too.
Knowing I've never won an argument with my daughter, I called. Now, 30 pounds later.
He's the fabulous Fabian again.
Now pay for a 10-pound program and lose the rest for free at Nutrisystem, the number one rated program by Healthline magazine. Call 1-800-321-THIN.
Big bones may be impressive, but not in a chicken. That's why I developed the Purdue breed. It has smaller bones and more breast meat than the competition. These two birds are the same weight, but Purdue gives you more breast meat, and this guy gives you more bone. So if you like more tender, juicy breast meat, buy Purdue. If you like bones, try the other guy, or come on down here.
Boy, did you see them mess up that handoff? The Sergeant, did you diagram that play? You see everything from these penthouse suites.
Even a midget like you, McDonald. The view's good, but I go for the comfort and good food.
Guys who don't appreciate this fine living are jerks or linebackers.
Yo, penthouse suites are great for the view.
It's the comfort.
Whatever your business, you'll do it better in a penthouse suite at the Vet. Call the Eagles at 334-1350 for the view and the comfort.
Your horoscope says a more colorful year will emerge this fall.
Announcing Fava's looking forward to fall sale. Be the first in all the latest fall suedes, the latest fall shades, the latest fall looks at the lowest fall prices.
While seeking the perfect match, you'll meet a most compatible sign.
It's Fava's looking forward to fall sale.
I love having something to look forward to.
You go far in Fava's.
Tomorrow on Evening Magazine, football season is here, and while the stars of the show are the players, the cheerleaders are the co-stars. They add glitz, glamour, and pizzazz to the game. What does it take to be an Eagles cheerleader? You'll find out on the next Evening Magazine. That's our show for tonight. Thanks for joining us.
Now, earlier in the show, we told you how a lot of Canadians have invaded Hollywood. We're going to leave you tonight with a young singer from north of the border. Her name is Celine Dion, and the song is Where Does My Heart Beat Now? Have a good night, everybody.
So much to believe in, we were lost in time. Everything I needed fell into your eyes. Always thought of keeping your heart next to mine. But now that seems so far. Don't know how love could leave. from the thunder. Come and rescue me. Driven by the hunger of the endless dream.
A Philadelphia man is stabbed to death by a known punk who had been in jail. He hadn't escaped. He had signed his way out.
1,000 murders in the last 3 years committed by people who should have been in jail.
The issue tonight, should criminals be allowed to sign themselves out of jail? Following First Sports and First Weather at 11.
At 6:17, you can be enjoying your morning jog.
Up to date on the business world.
And by 6:25, know how things will run on Wall Street. Newsday with Pat Scirocco and Dick Sheeran. News, weather, traffic. No waiting.
From KYW3, this is the News Now.
Good evening, I'm Jennifer Ward. A woman convicted of plotting a murder so her daughter could become a cheerleader has been hit with a stiff jail sentence, 15 years behind bars. The funeral for 9-year-old Samantha Russ was held today in Pleasantsville, New Jersey. And a judge is ordering teachers in 2 South Jersey districts to go back to work. More news in 1 hour.
I listen to KYW 2, 3, 4 times a day.
2, 3, 4 times a day.
2, 3, 4, 5 times a day. It's the only station on my radio.
KYW News Radio 1060.
I know at my own convenience.
I listen to KYW 2, 3, 4 times a day.
2, 3, 4 times a day.
2, 3.
2, 3. 2, 3, 4 times a day. I wish you could listen to it more often, really.
KYW News Radio 1060.
Hey, which of these 2 premium beers do you genuinely prefer?
This beer right here is much better.
This is Miller Genuine Draft, and here's Coors Extra Gold Draft.
Oh my God, I don't believe it.
57% of premium beer drinkers preferred Coors Extra Gold in a recent taste test.
I guess I'm one of them.
Want to know something else?
Hit me.
Coors Extra Gold was judged best premium lager at the Great American Beer Festival.
I wouldn't doubt that.
Slow brewed for that real beer flavor and color, the way beer was meant to be, which may be why it's taste.
Pull the Miller out of the water.
Coors Extra Gold. If you're missing real taste, beer is bad.
I'm definitely going to get into the gold.
Clean up on Royal Dirt Devil Vacuums and save at Strawbridge and Clothier. For the smallest jobs, use the lightweight yet powerful hand vac. The Dirt Devil is perfect for cleaning your car or van. With the upright, everything you need is right at your fingertips. Find your Royal Dirt Devil on sale now at Strawbridge and Clothier's Housewares Sale and Show.
A Current Affair, weekdays here on KYW-23.
Don't miss the emotion, the excitement, and the extraordinary moments of the Miss America pageant. September